Okay, thank you. Now, I can bottle these hot licks up here on hand if you want me. We can sell those, probably make some money. This evening, we're going to go back a few years. Every concert I do, I try to have a theme of some kind, where it's informative, educational for the students who are here, and I hope entertaining for everybody else. Tonight, we're going to go back into the swing era and play some songs and all kinds of things we'll be doing up here. So that one was, I can re-put my music together. I forgot what the name of it is. That's a Plenty, written by Kid Ory. Next one is a song that I pulled way out of the past. Guys in the band never heard of it. Many of the people on this faculty have never heard of it. But it was written by Benny Goodman. Billie Holiday recorded it. I used to play in Dallas a lot with players. And I was there. And it's entitled, If Dreams Come True. So some of you old-timers out there, you may remember it, but you may not know about the title, but when you hear the melody, it may ring back a bell. Ring a bell or something. Here goes, If Dreams Come True.
Come true.
I see we have a critic down here, and she must like the piano player, is that right? Oh, hi, darling. How many people remember that song? Let me see your hands. Anybody? Yeah, okay, very few. Great, great standard. Oh, yeah, KP. Let me introduce the gentleman up here on the stage. On piano, we have Mr. Kevin Bales. On bass, Scott Smith. And on drums, we have Steve Bucky Silverstein. Here's another song. Now, all of these songs I'm picking tonight generally were played by horn players, but many guitar players have played over the years, myself included. George Barnes was one that played really this style better than anybody else, and he played like Dixieland ideas on the guitar. That was his main bag, and he was also the one who was the first person to ever record the electric guitar, way before anybody. Okay, now, this next song is written by Kid Ory, nothing more than Muscat Ramble.
Carter's still trying to get a line up here.
Now, before the swing era, the most popular instrument in the rhythm section with strings on it besides the piano was a banjo. Many banjo players changed over to guitar during the 30s and the 40s. Some of them had a hard time because the banjo, he played very hard. But they carried that style over into the guitar. So, but the guitar had more interesting harmonies and more complex things, so, but they still would adapt to it. So, I'm going to do a song in that vein for you. It's a George Gershwin song entitled Liza, Till the Clouds Go By. And a piano player up here, Kevin and all the other guys, we can take a little break right now. You stay here.
Has he been taking lessons from you, Dad?
Yeah, I've been
sorry. Showing him a few?
He's got a very good learner.
No?
Real slow. Doesn't want to work hard.
Is that right?
Try. You tell these kids to work and they want to do something.
Do as I say, not as I do.
No respect for their
All right. Myself, I grew up in the Southwest and around the Dallas-Fort Worth area. There were a few songs that, when you go on a gig, a leader will look at you and say, "Do you know this?" And it was wise that you did know it, or you wouldn't be called again. You know, there were certain requirements. And one of them was this line there. It's called Little Rock Getaway, which is an old dictionary tune, but it's a little awkward if you're not familiar with it. And so I had to learn that written by an old ragtime piano player who also wrote Dizzy Fingers. His name was Zez Comfrey. Interesting thing about that song, it was very popular, and it was written around 1920. And it's the meter of it is like 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. That's what it sounds like, but it's really 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1. It's like the meter is 3 against 4, 4 time. And it was very interesting that that song was very popular because of that unusual rhythm at that time, in that time space. So now we're going to do a song that I can barely, really well, but I used to have to do NOLA, but I don't want to do it tonight. But we're going to do one called Tico Tico. It was considered that if you could play it, well, you're considered the guitar player. If you couldn't play it, well, go home, practice. So here's Tico Tico.
Ready, go.
Now comes a portion here. By the way, we're going to have a guest artist sitting with us on the second set, so please stay around. I won't tell you who he is, but his initials are BG. Doesn't stand for Benny Goodman. He works at the school, and he's my boss, so stick around for the second set. Right? But he's, you know, he's a mystery guest. Okay. Now comes a portion in the swing era where that was very prevalent where I grew up. Many people have a different or a misconception of this music. It started in the Fort Worth, Dallas area, and when I was growing up, it was called Western Swing. Later on, it was called Country Jazz. It's even been called Log Cabin Jazz. I think now they call it Texas Swing. But it so happens that I started out playing on these Western Swing bands, and I always thought they were country, you know, until I went on and played on one, and I found out something. It was like when I was going as a student to North Texas State University, then North Texas State Teachers College in Denton, Texas, all the guys, we play, you know, have jam sessions. We play tunes like I'll Remember April, Lady Be Good, Cherokee, and all these tunes that they still play, which is standard jazz repertoire. And, you know, with all the horn players and stuff, and I thought I was really cool, you know, playing all these tunes. I went on this band, you know, here comes a singer singing all the usual country tunes, and then they play an instrumental, and they play I'll Remember April, Cherokee, you know, all the Lady Be Good, all these tunes, and boy, they play better than what I heard at the school. These guys, it just so happened that they played instruments that were always associated with country music, but these guys were phenomenal jazz players, especially some of the violin players. I saw this one guy who had two bowls, and he would take one and loosen all the hair and turn it upside down and put it across the neck and bow underneath the neck where it covered all strings. And we were playing Cherokee at a very good tempo, and he was playing it all in chords. That was the darnest thing I ever saw. I mean, that was really something. So we're going to do a few of those songs now. And one guy I want to pay tribute to that was always always admired a lot, his name was Jimmy Bryant. He was from Georgia, and he moved to L.A., and he was on late 40s through the 50s. He was on so many recordings out there for Capitol Record. He was their number one guitarist. He was hearing behind people like Molly B. and A-Star and Tennessee Ernie Ford and all these popular singers. But then he would put out albums where he'd play, and it could be touch on country, but when he'd solo, it was always in a jazz idiom. And he was always linked with a guy on steel guitar named Speedy West. So I'm going to play one of Speedy's songs, and it's entitled Swinging on the Streams.
Thank you. Thank you.
Next song is a Jimmy Bryant. Also, it's entitled Bryant's Bounce. And you music majors, I'll tell you what, this is a key of D. Listen to the chord changes. Maybe we'll pull this one on you in improv class and there's that. Listen carefully. Years the guitar had a twangy sound, you know, so this is a pretty mellow sounding guitar, but there's a way of making it sound the other way, you know, it's where they, you know, well, I don't want to do that. Jimmy Bryant, And on this particular recording he had a great jazz violin player with him. He was a very close friend of Stump Smith. And this is called Jamming with Jimmy. You can hear him all yelling on the record. It gets really romping, you know. So here we go. You can relate this, the chord changes, to Opus 1, more or less, with a different bridge. So you can hear some of that in their lines, too. So here's Jamming with Jimmy.
Thank you.
will be back after show later. Thank you. With my very dear friend, Bucky Green, on the saxophone, is going to join us. And this set will not consist of Western swing, I'll tell you that right now. So, what's the first song we're going to do here? We're going to do a Kurt Weill song entitled Speak Low, which was introduced in a movie called Touch of Venus. Venus. With Ava Gardner and again Dick Haynes, who took Frank Sinatra's place with Tom Dorsey's band. Of course, I don't think you really want to know that, but here we go. We speak low. Thank you. you know, this young man up here playing all these notes on the saxophone. His real forte for me is playing a ballad, so I'd like to enter, you know, have Bucky play for us, Smoke It's In Your Eyes. Written by Jerome Kern. Originally this song was a little melody that played a vamp between scenes and a show. If you want to know the, how I got started, of course, maybe not. Here's Smoke It's In Your Eyes.
I just hope I get the scholarship from the out-of-state waiver.
Thank you. She's a graduate. All right.
But she's still one of our very own, nevertheless. Okay. Estamos listos? Get ready. I present to you the UNF Faculty Convoy.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.